Let us continue the previous module, that is module 1. We are going to start the new topic, that is HDFS user commands. What are the different user commands are present in Hadoop distributed file system? So the preferred way to interact with HDFS in Hadoop version 2 is through the HDFS command. How we can communicate, interact with Hadoop? These are the commands. With the help of command, we can interact with Hadoop. In version 1, Hadoop DFS commands was used to manage files in HDFS and DFS command. What is the significance of DFS command is run a file system command on the file system supported in Hadoop. So it runs a file which is supported by Hadoop, supported in the Hadoop. Next is name node format. As I said, every Hadoop will have at least one name node. So name node format, which is like a master master node, we can say, or which manages all the data nodes. So name node format, this command, what it does, it formats the DFS file system secondary name node. It runs the DFS secondary name node. So as I said that secondary name node is also present in the HDFS. So secondary name node command, it runs the DFS secondary name node. Name node runs the DFS name node. Journal node run the DFS journal node. JKFS run the JK failover controller daemon. Data node, it run a DFS data node. DFS admin, it runs a DFS admin client node. HAA admin run a DFS high availability admin client. FSCK, it run a DFS file system checking utility. Balancer, run a cluster balancing utility. JMX get the JMX exported values from name node or data node. Next set of commands are JMX get. It get, this command get the JMX exported values from the name node or data node. Next is mover command. It runs a utility to move block replica across storage types. OIV, it apply the offline FS image viewer to an FS image. OIV legacy, it apply the offline FS image viewer to an legacy FS image. OEV, it apply the offline edit viewer to an edit file. Fetch edit, this command, it signifies fetch a delegation token from the name node. Get configuration, this command get the configuration values from the configuration. Next set of commands are groups. This command, what it does, it get the group which users belong to. As is like every user belongs to some group. So you want to find out any user, it belongs to which group, so you can put the command groups. So get the groups which users belong to. Snapshot diff, diff two snapshots of a directory or difference the current directory contents with a snapshot. ls snapshot table directory. List all snapshot table directories owned by the current user. Use help to see options. Port map. Run a port map service. NFS 3. Run an NFS version 3 gateway. Cache admin. It configure the HDFS cache. Crypto. It configure the HDFS encryption zones. Storage policies. So in HDFS, storage area will also be there where data can be stored. So storage policy command, what it does, it get all the existing block storage policy. It creates a policy of the all existing block storage in the data nodes. Because when a client wants to write some data in the data node, then name node need to identify where the enough memory is present in which data node, which can be provided to the client to write their data. So using this command, storage policy, we can get all the existing block storage policy. Version. Print, it print the version of the HDFS. Most commands print help when invoked without parameters. Next one we are going to come is HDFS provides a series of commands similar to those found in standard POSIX file system. First, to list the files in the root HDFS directory, enter the following command. If you want to enter the root directory of the HDFS, we have to enter the following command, that is $HDFS -ls /. This front slash, it signifies the root directory. Next, to list the files in home directory, enter the following command, HDFS -l, only root directory will not be. If you put the root directory, it will list out the all the files present in the root directory. If you want to print, display all the files present in the home directory, so HDFS -l, make a directory in HDFS. Using the command HDFA, DFS -mkdir stuff. Using this command, we can create a directory in the HDFS. Copy file to HDFS. How we can copy a file to HDFS? To copy a file from your current local directory into HDFS, use the following command. HDFS -put -put test stuff. So it copies, to copy a file from your current local directory into HDFS. So it will enter the HDFS. It copies the data from put to the stuff. The file transfer can be configured by using the -ls command. It can be configured using -ls command. HDFS -ls stuff found one item. So using this command, we can configure any file. Now copy file from HDFS. Files can be copied back to your local file system using the following command, HDFS -get stuff test local. We can copy a file from HDFS to the local file system. How we can delete a file present in the HDFS? Using the command HDFS -rm test.hdfs. Using this command, test.hdfs file can be removed from the HDFS. Delete a directory in the HDFS. How we can delete a directory? Using the command HDFS DFS minus